This was not the language of compromise. President Trump described the situation at the border as a crisis of the heart and soul, a choice between justice and injustice, and he framed this fight as not just about politics and the border wall, but as his sworn duty to the American people.
Women and children are the biggest victims, by far, of our broken system. This is the tragic reality of illegal immigration on our southern border. This is the cycle of human suffering that I am determined to end.
The response from Democrats was equally passionate. Nancy Pelosi accusing Trump of seeding malice and misinformation. Chuck Schumer saying the president is throwing a temper tantrum inside the White House.
Most presidents have used Oval Office addresses for noble purposes. This president just used the backdrop of the Oval Office to manufacture a crisis, stoke fear, and divert attention from the turmoil in his administration.
Also important is what was not said. The president did not declare a national emergency, a move that would have given him the authority to build the wall without congressional approval. Now, Republicans are split over whether to even pursue that strategy, but conservatives remain committed to the wall, and that means there is still no end in sight to the shutdown. Now, later on today, President Trump will meet with congressional leadership at the White House. He'll also have lunch with Republicans in the Senate. But right now, it does look like the length of the shutdown will likely hit a new record. Back over to you guys.
Is there anything that you see in the upcoming days that would turn into a new inflection point? I know he's going to go down to the border, and there's going to be cameras and all of that, but I think this morning, at least the conventional wisdom is that last night was a nothing burger all around. We heard the same thing from the Democrats. We heard the same thing from President Trump. There was nothing new that really changed the conversation.
If anything, both sides seem even more dug in now with the president sort of publicly taking such a strident and strong position on funding for a border barrier. You are hearing, again, some growing rumblings amongst moderate Republicans. I think Lisa Murkowski is now out saying that she would support reopening parts of the government while that border security negotiation is ongoing. Three other Senate Republicans had previously indicated they would also support that measure. There's another Republican who has implied that she would be behind that as well, Shelley Moore Capito. So you were hearing some discontent perhaps from moderates, but that was part of the whole point right. of Mike Pence going to the Hill yesterday and the president and Mike Pence again revisiting with Senate Republicans today is to shore up that support and make sure that the party is unified behind the strategy.
How much does this change after Friday when federal employees don't get their paycheck?
I don't know. I mean, we know that Friday is coming. We know that employees have already seen smaller paychecks. They have been able to avert the crisis of the Coast Guard not getting paid. So I don't know if that really moves the ball. We've seen so many times already the sort of Main Street real world impact of the shutdown, but it hasn't yet been enough to force both sides to the table. I'm not sure that Friday is a real milestone in that.